Donald Trump, former president of the United States, had a big announcement to make. He wanted to make sure everyone who supports him purchases his new NFT trader card. Here it is.
Hello everyone, this is Donald Trump. Hopefully your favorite president of all time, better than Lincoln, better than Washington, with an important announcement to make.
All right, important announcement. What is that announcement, Mr. Former President?
I'm doing my first official Donald J. Trump NFT collection right here and right now. They're called Trump Digital Trading Cards. These cards feature some of the really incredible artwork pertaining to my life and my career. It's been very exciting. You can collect your Trump digital cards just like a baseball card or other collectibles. Here's one of the best parts. Each card comes with an automatic chance to win amazing prizes like dinner with me. I don't know if that's an amazing prize, but it's what we have. Or golf with you and a group of your friends at one of my beautiful golf courses, and they are beautiful. I'm also doing Zoom calls, a one-on-one meeting, autographing memorabilia, and so much more. We're doing a lot. My official Trump digital trading cards are $99, which doesn't sound like very much for what you're getting. Buy one and you will join a very exclusive community. It's my community, and I think it's something you're going to like, and you're going to like it a lot. They also make perfect gifts, so you can buy them with your credit card or crypto. All you need is an email address. Go to collecttrumpcards.com and buy your Trump digital trading cards right now before they are all gone, and they will be gone.
Donald Trump is a crackhead. Obviously, this was one of those moves where you have to scratch your head and wonder, well, damn, is he hard up for money? What is happening here? Will his followers all start purchasing these NFT Donald Trump trading cards? Well, here's what Steve Bannon said.
Okay, I got it. I got it. I can't watch it again. Make it stop. On a day when you have one of the most important announcements about really the coup and about big tech oligarchs involvement in it and what's going to happen and how we're going to clean out this mess. And the sense of urgency, I think it has to start now. That's why President Trump's got to get engaged in this omnibus, because we have the ability to execute on his plan now, although you don't control the White House, as command by negation with the House and the appropriations bill. This thing comes out and this whatever. And they said yesterday is going to be a big announcement. Look, I thought the announcement could be, people are coming to me, is he going to announce for Speaker? Is he going to
announce for Speaker? Sir, do you know how much money he can make from the NFT trade industry? Speaker, come on. Okay, so Steve Bannon, he represents the old white male Trump continuum. He's on one side of the spectrum. What about, let's say, a young black male Trump supporter? How do they feel about his new commercial? Here it is.
Once upon a time, America was at the brink of destruction. And Trump said he had a major announcement. Everyone gathered round. The left ran in fear. They were ready to run. The right celebrated. The savior has come. He said he has a major announcement. Everyone gathered round. And the announcement came. Cards. We were at the brink of destruction. Cards? Cards for $99. You gotta laugh sometimes. You've gotta laugh.
Yeah, Christian Walker, son of Herschel Damn Walker. You're right. You have to laugh, not to cry. You all are the ones who produced Donald Trump. We told you not to. We warned you. It was a con artist, snake oil salesman. He sold you a false bill of goods. You purchased it. And now, for some reason, it seems as if the spell is wearing off. Literally, a person who's going to prison for Donald Trump said, I can't believe I'm going to prison for an NFT salesman. Let's put his picture up. Baked Alaska, notorious capital rioter. Baked Alaska was suddenly filled with regret over his life decisions after watching former President Donald Trump hawk digital trading cards in a video in which he also declared himself a better president than George Washington. Baked Alaska, who earlier in the day said he believed Trump's digital card gambit means he can't win in 2024, wrote a follow-up in which he questioned his own decision to storm the Capitol building on January 6th, 2021. So all of a sudden, they are questioning these dynamics. Let's put up the message from Baked Alaska. He says, I can't believe I'm going to jail for an NFT salesman. Believe it, sir. Believe it. When you are incarcerated, I want you to remember every day of your life that you are in jail, away from your family and friends, your racist support groups. You are in that position because you decided to support and commit acts of crime for a person who would rather sell you a damn fake ass NFT card. They're not even real. Look at the pictures. Can we put up one of the pictures really quickly? Donald Trump said, this is about my life story. When in the hell has Trump ever been that person or Superman or an astronaut? Although Baked Alaska was once a major Trump supporter in his first two presidential campaigns, he has now apparently switched his allegiance to rapper Kanye West, the leader of the White Lives Matter movement, Kanye West, who has taken to openly praising Nazi dictator Adolf Hitler and denying the Holocaust ever happened. Earlier this year, Baked Alaska pleaded guilty to a misdemeanor count of parading, demonstrating, or picketing inside a Capitol building, for which he faces up to 6 months in prison. Should have been arrested, obviously, for domestic terrorism. He was not. Now, here's the reality. Every single one of us, well, maybe not all of us, but the vast majority of those who consume this program, we have always known Donald Trump was a con artist, a salesman, an individual who is low quality in a high quality suit. That is it. That's all he has ever been. Nothing less, nothing more. Was it the racism of Trump that caused his followers to say, whoa, wait a minute, that's too far? No. Was it when he mocked the disabled? Was that when his followers said, wait a minute, Trump? No. Was it when he protected racists and said, they're actually very good people, by the way? That didn't do it. How about when he proclaimed how he likes to sexual assault women? They were good with that. But damn it, he went too far trying to sell them NFT trading cards. Now the game has completely changed. Ironic to say the least. My dear brother, what are your thoughts here?
It always seems to be when the shoe is on the other foot that you start to get the actual response back for them. I mean, we have to remember back from 2016, the night of the election, when a lot of people thought wrongfully that Hillary Clinton was going to win, that Donald Trump had already set up his post-election venture. It was going to be Trump TV, who's going to have a competitor to Fox News. He already had him set up on election night in Trump Tower. But then he was surprised, everyone was, well, a lot of people were surprised in saying in that Donald Trump won the 2016 election. So before that, there were Trump stakes and Trump jets and all these other ventures, maybe like one out of 20 of these succeeded. Let's never forget that Donald Trump is one of the few people who has managed to go bankrupt while owning casinos, right? Like the house always wins and he still went bankrupt, all right? Like, not a smart guy over here, right? So it only happens when the shoe is on the other foot, when these conservatives start to feel that they're scammed, all right? So always remember that. Like the hypocrisy, of course, we expect the hypocrisy there. But note that deep down, all these people will feel once that they're scammed, it's too much for them. The Baked Alaska tweet where he's like, oh great, I'm going to jail for an NFT salesman. Pure schadenfreude. But I think my favorite part of the entire story was the fact that Donald Trump himself in that interview was had like no inflection to his voice, no enthusiasm, very low energy Donald there. He had all the enthusiasm of like a patient woman who realizes 15 seconds into the first date that she doesn't want to be here anymore. And she's just counting down to when her parking meter runs out to when she can finally get the hell out of there. Like, it was just so low charisma. This is, I mean, definitely not to speak of the anti-Semitism, the calling for the abolishing of the Constitution, the absolutely terrible run when it came to a lot of his key endorsements in the 2022 primaries. But Donald Trump ain't got the sauce. Like, this is that's not right. The same guy from 2016. And I could be wrong, we could all be fooled and surprised, but this is gonna be a much tougher time for him. And it is currently very fun to watch him stumble and fail like this.
I think your analysis is spot on. I do believe this is going to be a very different reality for Donald Trump than the first time he won that presidential cycle.